By the end of this video, you're going to know how to build AI agents using Zapier Central to take action based on content on a web page. These workflows are real-life useful workflows that I'm going to start using myself on a day-to-day basis. Let's get started. The first automation I'm going to show you is using Zapier Central's Chrome extension. So you just want to go to the Chrome Web Store and search for Zapier Central and add the extension to your browser. So here we have the Zapier Central extension open in our browser. What this allows you to do is easily access your Zapier Central bots directly in your browser and take action based on information that you're browsing with. So here we are on an article, and what we're going to do is summarize this article in one click. So I can go ahead on the right side, just click summarize this page. I also could just type summarize the page and click send. So here we go. Now the bot is going to read everything on the page that we're on, and then it's going to take action and give us a summary of that page. So that's a cool, simple action, but let's take this to the next level. Stay with me because I think you're going to really like this next part. So here on the left side, we're going to go into Zapier Central. We're going to go into a bot that I've been working on called Test Bots. I'm just using this to add different behaviors that I'm testing out. And I'm going to add a new behavior here to this video. So we're going to go ahead and click Behaviors, click Create Behavior. So a behavior is kind of like a workflow that we're going to add into our AI bot. So in this case, we're going to start this behavior when I message the bot. We're going to add a trigger, and the trigger phrase is going to be summarize and email. Because what I want to do is summarize the page and then email myself the resulting summary of the page. So the instructions to follow are going to be, please get a summary of the page that I'm on and send it as an email to myself at seth@nocode.mba. Because what I want to do is just when I'm on the article, something I might want to read in the future, and I just want to get it emailed to myself. So we're going to add actions for this. One thing I can do is click on suggested actions, and I can see there's a few suggestions already, and Gmail is one of them, of send email. So I'm going to go ahead, I could click add, I could also just click add action and choose Gmail, and click send email here. So make sure your Gmail is connected. In my case, it's already connected to my Gmail account, seth@nocode.mba, and it's just loading up the action info. So here we go. For two, I could either have AI generate the value, or I could specifically set it in and as seth@nocode.mba. I'm going to do that specifically, even though I do in the prompt tell it what email I want it to send to, which would make it really easy. But in this case, I'm just going to hard code it in, because in this, for this behavior, I only want to email myself. For CC, I'm going to say do not include a value. For BCC, I'm going to say do not include a value. From, we can just set a specific field and it'll just be from myself. From name, we can let AI generate that reply to. We can just say do not include a value for that field. Subject and body, we can have AI generate values for both of those fields. And then we can leave everything else as have AI generate a value. So I'm going to go ahead and click add action. So basically when I message the bot, summarize an email, we're going to get a summary of the page to tomorrow and send it as an email to myself. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and turn this on. The reason is that I don't know if we can test this behavior because it's getting a summary of the page that I'm on, which is more going to be something that the extension is going to be able to do when we're on a specific page. Now, I could probably test it by saying get a summary of this link, because Zapier Central can actually browse links that you put and browse the web. But let's leave it at this. Let's turn it on and let's test it out. So let's go back to this article that I'm on. I'm just going to refresh. Let's go into test bots, because that's the bot that I built that behavior on. And let's put in that trigger message, which is summarize and email. And let's click send. And let's see what happens. So here we go. It's running that behavior. And we can see that it's doing it. So it's first summarizing it, which is great. And now it is sending it to our email. So let's see if it does that successfully. Action progress, send email. Okay, awesome. So I should have just gotten an email with a summary. So let's see if that worked. And here we go. Here I am in my email, and I got a summary of that article, title and summary, so I could check it out later. And I could also add information to that behavior and say, hey, also add a link back to the page, so it'll be easy for me to get back to. There's a lot of cool things that I could do to customize that behavior with Zapier. So the key takeaway that you should have from this section is that you can use Zapier Central to take information about the page that you're on the website that you're browsing, and then take an action based on that data. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free videos like this one, and leave a comment if you have any questions at all. If you liked this video and want to dive deeper into building with AI and no-code tools, check the link in the description or go to No-Code MBA, an in-depth no-code learning platform where you'll learn how to build with AI and no-code tools with over 60 in-depth courses. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.